It's lovely to have a delegation here from the Curragh Racecourse, which is undergoing a transformation over in Ireland at the moment, and Derek is largely overseeing that. I imagine you're pretty busy, but lovely to get away for a few days.
Yeah, it's fabulous to come and see and visit some of the people who are helping us and supporting us to get to that end point. But yeah, very busy time, but a very exciting time for us as well.
Of course, one of the main reasons for your visit, you've got, as you say, very strong links with Dubai and the UAE through the Irish Derby sponsorship with Dubai Duty Free.
Yeah, magnificent support. It's been going back now to 2008, but even goes back further, 2002, when Dubai Duty Free first got involved with us. And the support is supporting our top race, and a race which this year was rated very highly in the global rating. So we're very excited about that. We've just renewed again for this year, and we'll be talking about the future. So that's a fabulous support, a partnership to have. But, you know, here in Dubai, we get a lot of support. Part of our development, we have support from Godolphin, and we have support from Sheikh Hamdan as well. So we're getting fabulous support, and it means that we can realise an ambition, which is to really transform the Curragh and make it Curragh. And something that, I suppose, achieves what people know about the Curragh, but perhaps hasn't really matched the expectation of what is known to be a fabulous track. Maybe off the track it hasn't been as good. So that's got to be a very exciting time for us to realise that in the next 12 months.
You put that very nicely, because it's home to all of the Irish classics. And now I guess it's time to just update the facilities and kind of make them match the action on the track.
Well, we see that with other sports. Maidan, I mean, obviously it's a fabulous, fabulous development. But we've seen with York, we've seen what Ascot have done. Longchamp are also redeveloping. So everybody realises that in order to be a successful business and attract people to come and enjoy your sport, you have to have the facilities to match that. And that's what the Curragh hasn't had for a long time. But now, of the Irish support of people from the industry who have finally said, okay, we got to make this happen. And they've really they're behind the wheel, and now we have some fantastic energy and real excitement and vision, and I suppose there's a dream that's to be realised for people who are involved in the industry, for local people in Curragh who just, you know, love the place, but now want to feel proud that there's somewhere they can come and really enjoy it.
And is the idea, as a lot of new sort of racecourse developments are doing, to make it so that on a normal Sunday afternoon, it feels comfortable and everyone sort of, it feels cosy, if you like, and then on the really big day like Dubai Duty Free Irish, sort of would expand further?
That's exactly the point. And it's to expand the facility to make it feel more comfortable. So literally, as opposed to the previous design, was a pretty linear relationship. You literally walked along the racetrack. We've literally put the parade ring in behind the new stand, and that deals with the prevailing wind right across the stand, and it's a fairly open space, so it's nice to have that action. The public will now come in from the north side as opposed to the east side. So there's a change in orientation side, so people will get a different perspective of the facilities and the track. So it's about changing the way the Curragh has made people feel comfortable or in the past. And I suppose, as you said, it's about finding the grandstands for the people who come for every day, and then the ability to expand out the site. And we're getting plenty of experience of that right now, because for 2 years of the development, we're racing in temporary facilities. So we're getting a very good flavour of what works and what type of facility, what people like, and because that is going to be part of our future as well. So.
And we can see the new Curragh when? When can we experience it for the first time?
Well, people can experience it this year. They're going to see a lot of the new elements, which we've got ready for racing this year. So we have a new parade ring, new saddling stalls, the new entrance arm and museum bingos will be in for this year. But the big finish is the grandstand, and that's really starting now. When people come racing this year, they'll see the structure of the skeleton come out of the ground, and then by the end of racing for Champions Weekend this year, it's pretty much the finished structure. We look to take it in December, and then ready for racing March 2019. So for next season's racing season, we'll be ready.